In 1928, he switched to heavyweight and fought his first fights in the United States. There, he met manager Joe Jacobs, who gave him the fight name the Black Ulan of the Rhine and brought him into the public eye. On June 12, 1930, Schmeling fought Jack Sharkey for the world heavyweight title. After an illegal low blow from Sharkey, Schmeling was declared world champion, the only boxer to receive his title in this way. Schmeling successfully defended his title against Young Stribling, but lost it in a rematch against Sharkey. During this time, he also met the film actress Annie Ondra, whom he married in 1933. In 1934, Schmeling defeated Walter Neusel in a fight that was watched by 100,000 people, a European record. The National Socialists demanded that Schmeling separate from his Czech wife and his Jewish manager, which he, however, refused to do. Schmeling fought Joe Louis in 1936 and won, which was considered a big surprise. The rematch in 1938 was won by Joe Louis after a knockout in 124 seconds. Schmeling was called up to serve in World War II in the Wehrmacht in 1940. He was deployed as a parachutist, was seriously injured during a jump, and had to be treated in a military hospital for months. Schmeling continued his career after the Second World War, but was unable to build on his earlier successes. He fought his last fight in Berlin in October 1948. He ended his career with 57 victories in 70 fights. His business career that followed was no less impressive. He took over general agencies for Coca-Cola products in Hamburg and Tübingen. He established the Max Schmeling Foundation for charitable purposes. In 1971, he was awarded the Grand Cross of the Order of Merit of the Federal Republic of Germany. Schmeling and his wife Annie Ondra remained married until her death in 1987. The couple had no children, but adopted a girl. Max Schmeling died on February 2, 2005, at the age of 99, in Wenzendorf, near Hamburg. Schmeling once said about his life, "I always fought fair in the ring and in life, and I try to do my best." Well, so much for Max Schmeling, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.